Hello, Randall Monk and Ronna Vezane here again with a gem of wisdom from Archangel Michael. And this comes from the May 2019 message. And let's see what we have here. Your encodings of awareness are constantly being modified by your positive or negative thoughts, intentions, and actions. You are being presented with tests of tolerance, benevolence, humility, and patience. And your cultural views are being challenged as well. Each and every day, the seed thoughts, which contain the negative frequency patterns of these aspects, will shrivel and disappear when you stop feeding them energy.
First of all, we're sitting in on my back patio in my backyard. I have a beautiful backyard, and we've had a lot of wonderful times out here. So Randy and I decided to move outside and enjoy the beautiful solstice. Today's the summer solstice, right?
Actually, it is summer solstice. Yes. That's right.
Yes. And so happy summer, everyone. And we love these times with you. As we are noticing, even though we are aware of what's going on in the world, our worlds are shrinking. Our circle of awareness is becoming very condensed, because we no longer agree to stay in situations. We are setting boundaries. We no longer go out in some of the areas that we've gone before where there is negativity and so on. And so we are choosing what we wish to experience. Setting boundaries is one of the great things that we need to do now. Archangel Michael says it's better to not do a thing than to do it for the wrong reason. And I, as you probably in the past, have done a lot of things out of duty, or because people expected of you, or because you wanted to be approved of. And so those things are changing, though we are changing, but we have to be careful, because we have to understand our best. We have to monitor our emotions and the things that we're doing, that we are feeling that it is optimal. In other words, for those little things in your world that are bothering you, like Michael said about, you're looking for what you want, your passion, what you really want to do. Eliminate those things that no longer bring you joy. For you're going to find that it is more important what we want to say. We have to stay centered. We have to learn to control our emotions. We have to focus on sending positive energy. See your radiance. See yourself as a sun, S-U-N. See a sun radiating forth from you. After a moment, an interaction or something, stop. How does that sun feel? Are you sending out love in beautiful concentric circles and radiating out from you? Or have you kind of shut down? Are you feeling it in your solar plexus? Begin to listen to your body consciousness. Your body elemental will begin to communicate with you more and more, and it will begin to tell you when you are a little off center, or when you are functioning from a belief that is not your highest good. We have an inner guidance, and it's becoming more prominent. That's your intuition, your illumination. The instinctual nature is still important, but move it up into your intuition. The more you listen to that little voice, the louder it's going to get. We know that's where we function. It's a gift to all of us. It's an intrinsic part of it, but it really hasn't been accessible to us until lately. Claim those gifts. Claim the peace and the joy. Be daring enough to do what's right for you.
I want to read that first quote again, that first sentence again. Your encodings of awareness are constantly being modified by your positive or negative thoughts, intentions, and actions. And first of all, I would like to add to that, and your emotions. For example, if somebody gets upset with us and pushes our button and we get angry, that's a negative emotion. That's a lower vibrational emotion, and that's going to take our energy signature vibration down, and the more we tap into that anger, the more we're going to draw angry people or people that are going to be confrontational into our life, because we're sending out that kind of signal. And as far as our thoughts, it's been shown via a book, what's the name of that book by Leadbeater and Andy Bissett?
Thought Forms.
Where people, clairvoyants, have seen the thought forms and have drawn them. The thoughts indeed are things. And whatever we're thinking, especially with feeling, is really going out more powerfully. And so I would encourage you to be present in the moment and monitor your thoughts and take a breath or two if somebody pushes your button, because nobody does anything to us. Everything is neutral until we decide if it makes us angry, because two people could experience the same thing. One gets angry and one laughs.
Like Michael said, you can tell how you're doing by the people you draw to you.
That's right, exactly. If you want to know how you're doing, look at the people in your environment, even strangers you're interacting with. What are they like? Are they friendly? Are they kind? And your close friends and that type of thing. So we can always tell by that and our circumstances in life. Much love and many blessings.
Till next time.
We love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye now.